I'm running each rail operator on the London rail map, and today is day two of Great Northern.
I've just recently set off in Finsey Park and heading up to Welling Garden City.
Running between Finsey Park and Welling Garden City is almost the total distance of a marathon.
It's quite a long way.
And just like that, I've made it to the first station.
Haringey Station. Let's keep it moving.
After Haringey, I soon arrived at
Hornsey Station.
But before I get to the next station, it's time for some trivia.
But you know, with Alexandra Palace Station, you've got the main line station that's just coming up. And I know that I've mentioned in a previous video that there used to be the second Alexandra Palace Station. But did you know that there was a third Alexandra Palace Station? And here is the third station at Alexandra Palace. This was the former Palace Gates Station. This was a terminus station on the Alexandra Palace branch line from Seven Sisters, which, if you're familiar, is on the London Overground. So back in the day, Palace Gates Station, Alexandra Palace, and Alexandra Palace again. Three stations.
And before I forget,
this is Alexandra Palace.
So at this point, the Great Northern Network splits in two, with one line heading up towards Harford North. New video on that next time. But today, we're continuing along the East Coast Main Line, where I stumbled across this questionable furniture.
I am tempted to sit in that, but I think I would catch leprosy if I did.
After running next to the North Circular, next up is New Southgate, where things were taking a turn for the worse.
So after leaving New Southgate, I haven't really been filming too much, and it's because the sun sets in half an hour and it's already getting pretty dark. So what I reckon I'm gonna do is finish at, I think, New Barnet. I'm gonna come back tomorrow, continue on from New Barnet, go to Welling Garden City and get here a bit early.
I soon make it to Oakley Park, and before I knew it, I was at New Barnet.
But at New Barnet Station, see you back here tomorrow morning.
13 hours later, I was back at New Barnet, ready to restart the run.
So at this point, from New Barnet over to Welling Garden City, I think it's 25k. Matt North, let's talk more running. Let's get running.
Half marathon remaining now. It wasn't long until I got to Hadley Wood, where, yep, you may have guessed it, more rail trivia.
So Hadley Wood was local to that of Sir Nigel Gresley, who, if you're not familiar, was the person behind the infamous Mallard steam train. It's the fastest ever steam train on record. And the first ever of its kind to be a truly high-speed train. And on a personal note, that train in particular is my favourite train. And another thing about Hadley Wood Station is that you recognise that this station has four tracks running through it. Was that always the case? No. Now, I believe at platforms 1 and 2 at Hadley Wood Station, that used to be the original two tracks that used to run through the station. So the tunnels on either side of the station was the original tunnel.
Passing Hadley Wood, we're now officially out of London and out in Hertfordshire. In case you can't tell, from all the countryside. Well, mostly.
Casually going over the M25.
But it's not long until I get to my first station out in Hertfordshire, where it raises this existential question.
So we got to Potter's Bar train station. Now, is this train station or railway station? Let me know down below. Anyway, we've got 10.2 miles remaining until we get to Welling Garden City, but I think there's four stations left. But at this point now, so from Potter's Bar over to the next station, we're going to be running adjacent to the railway the whole time. So, in case you can't tell, I'm very much looking forward to it. Does this face show? See? Yeah? Happy? Yeah? Okay, good. Right, let's get into it. I'm looking at Potter's Bar on the London rail map. Oh, Great Northern. But from looking at Potter's Bar on the London rail map, you'll notice it is the last station to accept Oyster. So from here on out, it is explicitly contactless only. You know what, I feel like it's so dramatic, but I feel like as if I'm in heaven at the minute. I'm out for a run, got the railways right next to me, got all the trains passing just next to me. Like, this feels, it feels correct. It feels correct.
And what also feels correct is the site of the first contactless-only station on the London rail map.
This is Brookmans Park. I did notice the contactless-only card reader that is at the station, so it clearly says in there,
no Oyster allowed.
Okay.
After checking some questionable road signs,
okay,
I soon arrived at the next station.
We're here at Welham Green Station. Now, this station is very unique. Why is that? Well, it's because this actually opened in the 80s. It's the newest station on this line to open. And what I found quite interesting about this station in particular, the ones that we've seen so far, they have the island platforms, so like the platforms in the middle. I mean, hence the name island platforms. This one here, they only have two platforms, and it's on either side of the main line. So you've got the fast tracks that's just in the middle, and then you've got the slow tracks on the outside for the local services.
I took a short break at the station before moving on, but while passing through Wellham Green, did you know that this here is known as Balloon Stone? Why is that? Well, in 1784, Italian balloonist Vincenzo Lunardi was making his first manned aerial voyage over England and briefly touched down right here.
But he was travelling with his cat and dog, and he sold his cat to one of the local people and kept his dog. But yeah, apparently that was the first ever sighting of a hot air balloon. Now the people that were living here at the time were like looking like, oh my god, what in the... She's never seen one before. But yeah, it was just a Italian adventurer travelling in his hot air balloon with his two pets.
It was 6 kilometres between Wellham Green and the next station, and I needed to get a move on, as time was of the essence.
It's Hatfield Station. It is also starting to get dark. I think by the time we get to Welling Garden City, there's going to be like no light in the sky. I just want to keep it moving. Let's get over to Welling Garden City. So we've just lost the GPS signal, but we've got about a mile remaining till we get to Welling Garden City. Welling Garden City. Whew. So that means for episode 14, I'm going to be running the last section of Great Northern from Alexandra Palace over to Hertford North. So it's going to be a very sad occasion as we say goodbye to Great Northern. It has been such a joy so far. So thank you, Great Northern. It has been a pleasure. On that note, thank you for coming along this journey with me. Thanks to those that support the channel on Patreon. If you like this type of content, click here to watch another video. Gosh, how many miles?